For Newsy, I'm Christian Bryant. What's black, white, and can't fly to save its life? We'll give you a hint. It's a bird. If you guessed penguin, then congrats. But enough funny business, because we have serious news. A new study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences might have figured out why these birds can't fly. There have been several theories as to why some birds become flightless, one being a lack of predators on the ground, causing them to have no need to use their wings. Thus, when they don't use them, they lose them. This recent study came to another conclusion. If you've ever heard the phrase, you can't have your cake and eat it too, then that's basically what this boils down to. The theory, biomechanical hypothesis. Stay with us. A researcher involved in the study told the BBC, when the bird is flying and diving, it has to use its wings to do two different things. The biomechanical hypothesis is that you cannot build a wing that is good at doing both. Scientists studied seabirds closely related to penguins and found wings that were good for water can't also be good for air, or rather, flying. But that's not to say there isn't a bird that can swim and fly. Take the guillemot, for example. It resembles ancient penguin ancestors, looks like a penguin, and can even swim pretty well. But unlike the penguin, it can fly. Researchers analyzed the amount of energy the bird exerted when it swam and flew. They found swimming was a relatively easy task, but when it came to flying, their wings were so short that it took a lot more work for them to stay in the air. And the bird still had to use more energy when diving compared to penguins, likely because they still had wings built for flight, which created a drag in the water. Scientists believe this could give significant insight as to how penguins ultimately became flightless by taking this trade-off one step further and giving up the ability to fly altogether in order to become more powerful swimmers. For Newsy, I'm Christian Bryant.